I get asked occasionally, do I want an advanced movement COD game to ever happen again, or a futuristic COD game? And this is a complicated question, because yes, I do, but if you were to tell me one is coming out, I wouldn't be excited. Basically, I don't want one right now, but I don't mind the idea of them playing with the idea in the future. Now, what universe would I want it to take place in? Probably either Advanced Warfare in the form of a sequel, or in the Black Ops universe between Black Ops 2 and 3. But the movement system really doesn't concern me as much as the maps. You see, I didn't mind Black Ops 3 and Infinite Warfare and Advanced Warfare, but my problem really came down to the maps. I found them to be incredibly limiting, and to this day I don't know why. Why make these advanced movement systems that are more vertical and dynamic and fluid and fast, and put them in these very restricting areas? Now, some DLC maps I think really stand out, and in some ways, Advanced Warfare did theirs the best because their system was pretty simple. You could go up higher, so the maps were made with more verticality. But when it comes to Infinite Warfare and Black Ops 3, I think their main weaknesses are their maps, is because you have these really cool, fluid systems. They feel like they're kind of ripped out of Titanfall while still feeling like their own thing, but they just don't work for me because they're in these really boring arenas. You see, a lot of people had this problem with stuff like Assassin's Creed 3. The parkour in Assassin's Creed 3 isn't bad, it's just where you do the parkour isn't very interesting. I think the more options you give to players, a more dynamic play space you give to players, the more the game feels replayable. It's not just a matter of the competition, it's the experience of actually being in whatever game's world you're in. Challenges come and go, but the experience of completing the challenge, or rising up to it, or attempting it, you know, those are the things I think really make good games into great games. And when talking about shooters, it takes them from competitions into experiences, which are way more interesting to me. So if I wanted an advanced movement COD game, dynamicness would have to be at the forefront of the design, because otherwise you're just moving fast in a cardboard box, which is how I felt in Infinite Warfare and Black Ops 3, except for a couple of DLC maps. Now, size does not equal quality. Variety doesn't equal quality. In fact, variety in and of itself has a quality, but it often reduces the ability for developers to focus down and make a balanced experience. When you go for variety, or a sort of freedom of abuse as to what the player can do, the game's balance and competitiveness definitely struggles, and the pacing struggles, but each individual player will be doing their own thing, and it'll feel more substantial to the individual. These, of course, are not universal things, and these are just from my experience playing a lot of different FPS games and video games in general. Let me put it to you this way. Growing up, I realized very early on that I much prefer to go throughout my entire subdivision, my whole neighborhood, with my friends with airsoft guns or Nerf guns, where we didn't know where the other person would be, we didn't know where they were going or what road they were going to take or what sidewalk they were going to be on, which introduced a lot of variety and a lot of funny moments. Nothing like leaving your front porch to go to the other side of the neighborhood to go set up by the pond waiting for your friends to come to, then you can ambush them, to then walking back home and seeing that your friend hid in your garage. That's funny. Is it a big waste of time how much walking I had to do? Yeah, but there was something about it. There was like a mystery. What was gonna happen next? I much preferred that than going to a paintball field or like a speedball event. I found that to be tedious, annoying, repetitive, fast. Yeah, maybe more skill was involved, but it didn't matter to me. I was genuinely having a lot less fun. In success and defeat, I was simply not mentally engaged. So let's say we have a COD game coming out and it has advanced movement. What kind of advanced movement do I want? Well, the first thing I'm going to tell you is that I don't want thruster packs or exosuits. I find the jetpacking around thing to be kind of tedious and annoying for gameplay, and not very fulfilling to the player. Letting somebody shoot themselves into the air, either at an angle or straight up, and then to change direction mid-flight with a thrust or something like that, I don't think that's really engaging you. What we definitely want is wall running. Titanfall got this right, many other shooters have gotten this right, and I do think Call of Duty got the mechanic right, but they got, again, the arenas wrong. Wall running is good because it makes you study your environment, it makes you look around where you are and assess where you can go. So we definitely want wall running. We also want mantling, but we don't want the mantling to be too high or the jump to be too high. That way, people are just going to see a window above them and then jump right into it. What we want is a smooth and tactile experience of being able to jump to a ledge, grab it, go up, and carry our momentum to the next ledge. So a sort of momentum-based first-person parkour-like thing is what you might be thinking of, and that's exactly what I'm describing. If you press A to get on top of a ledge and then look up and press A again, I want that animation to be smooth and clean. This adds a lot of possibilities for where you can be, and while that might not always be the most balanced, if you're designing a shooter with advanced movement in mind, I don't think you're going to get the most competitive skill-based setup. I think you're going to get a lot of people doing a lot of weird, wacky things with the movement that are going to be unpredictable. But I think being in the air is the boring part. I think it's where you can land. That's what makes it interesting. That makes you study the environment. So these play spaces don't need to just have ledges and things you can climb on top of and jump from part to part to and then wall run on. They also need to just be large. I think when you speed up player movement, it has to be large to accommodate it. One of the things I'm noticing in Black Ops Cold War is that Raid, being one of my favorite multiplayer maps, isn't playing the way I remember. And it's not by accident. Black Ops 2 didn't have unlimited sprint. Your positioning is much more important when you can't get away freely. And that's why I like the idea of a sprint being not very fast, but also having attack sprint, or just having limited sprint in general. There are people out there with glass thumbs that complain about their thumbs hurting after long play sessions. That is the most nerdy first world issue in the world, and I won't hear it. But we're talking about an advanced movement game here, so limited sprint really wouldn't cater to that. We want to have fast, unlimited sprint, wall running, and the ability to clamber and mantle on things, and also jump off of things. Battlefield 5 nailed this with its tactical roll feature. As soon as you hit the ground, your character initiates into a somersault, and that needs to happen in an advanced movement Call of Duty game, or at least something similar. But if the play space is small and cramped, you're just gonna be bumping into people all the time. It'll feel like a damn clusterfuck. Or at the very, very worst, in my opinion, it'll just feel incredibly repetitive. So let's shake that repetitiveness by adding big, large, dynamic maps. Maps in the vein of Call of Duty Ghosts. Ghosts had large maps. It had little interactable environments, and that needs to be expanded upon. We want turrets. We want walls that can be blown open, gas stations that can be knocked down, gates that can be closed. We want opening and closing doors that you're able to leap through or kick down and also blow up and knock them off the hinges. We want garage doors that you close them, but they don't close all the way. They stop at a certain point at sliding height. So if a garage door is about to close on you, and you can't get to the objective for whatever reason, you slide underneath it. I want prominent wall running spots that can be shot at with rocket launchers, and if it's hit with enough rockets and grenades and C4, it eventually breaks, turning it into something that you have to cross. So you run, jump, and then wall run on the other side of it, basically creating a gap to cross. I want zip lines, like in Black Ops 1, sort of scattered around certain maps. And you might think, boom, you're describing a massive clusterfuck, but I don't think that I am. I'm describing a system where it would still be the traditional 6v6 Call of Duty multiplayer. We're not trying to reinvent the wheel here. We just want each match you play to feel different. And your options when it comes to movement need to be plentiful and require you to pay attention. This is more mentally engaging, at least as far as I'm concerned. If you give me 3-lane maps and the ability to double jump and wall run again, I'm just going to be bored. But you give me a map like Stonehaven or a map like Derailed, and you tell me that I can wall run, jump off of high things, and tuck and roll before I hit the ground. I can interact with parts of the map, destroy parts of the map, operate turrets, parkour on various ledges in a smooth and intuitive way. I can one-hand my gun and shoot while mantling. I can hip-fire my gun while sliding. There's really only one thing that you'd have to assure me of, that I can avoid these dynamic elements in the parkour and the turrets and just play Call of Duty traditionally. Yeah, maybe I'll be forced to use a wall run spot here and there, but I want to be able to, if I want to, play conservatively, play stealthy around the edges of the map for my streaks, or push the objectives without having to worry about 100 gimmicks being in my way. But scale and gimmicks are important. If you're going to create an advanced movement game, I'm going to assume that the reason you're doing this is to add variety and intrigue to an otherwise old formula. You can't just give me the ability to go high on boring maps and expect me to be happy. So I need that dynamicness. I need that little bit of intrigue, where maybe I'll never have to fire my pistol from a ladder, or blow up that one wall, or mantle these two little ledges outside of a window to get to a height advantage. Maybe I'll never have to use those. But when you create a game to be like a sandbox, the idea is that not everything is going to be used all the time, but it's always on the table. That way, when you play a map 6 times in a row, let's say, maybe you have different experiences each time. So to summarize, my ideal advanced movement Call of Duty is interactive, large, and the movement doesn't need to be shooting you up in the air like a crazy person. No, I think being able to wall run, mantle things in a quick succession, being able to take a long fall, you mix that with dynamic and interactive maps, beautiful graphics, customizable weapons, maybe even some light day and night, time-changing, weather-changing effects on the maps. Honest to God, I think you'll have a very, very replayable and interesting Call of Duty. Gamers will try to get the most amount of fun out of any video game. They will try to optimize the amount of fun they're having in any video game. But you have to give them a variety of tools so that those experiences can happen in a way that feels natural. Seeing how that's my favorite design philosophy when it comes to Call of Duty, I really think that wall running is the right choice because it again makes you have to utilize your environment and assess your environment, where a thruster pack doesn't really make you have to do that. You just sort of go up and then grab a ledge and that's it. I know this video wasn't very interesting, but I want to know if you guys have any interest in the topic. Either way, I'll see you when I see you. Goodbye.